The world would be happier if men had the same capacity to be silent that they have to speak. Be not astonished at new ideas, for it is well known to you that a thing does not therefore cease to be true because it is not accepted by many. If men were born free, they would, so long as they remained free, form no conception of good and evil. I would warn you that I do not attribute to nature either beauty or deformity, order or confusion. Only in relation to our imagination can things be called beautiful or ugly, well-ordered or confused. I have striven not to laugh at human actions, not to weep at them, nor to hate them, but to understand them. Nothing in the universe is contingent, but all things are conditioned to exist and operate in a particular manner by the necessity of the divine nature. For peace is not mere absence of war, but is a virtue that springs from a state of mind, a disposition for benevolence, confidence, justice. Whatsoever is contrary to nature is contrary to reason, and whatsoever is contrary to reason is absurd. To give aid to every poor man is far beyond the reach and power of every man. Care of the poor is incumbent on society as a whole. It may easily come to pass that a vain man may become proud and imagine himself pleasing to all when he is in reality a universal nuisance. The highest activity a human being can attain is learning for understanding, because to understand is to be free. All happiness or unhappiness solely depends upon the quality of the object to which we are attached by love.